What up, what up? Winbush here. And today I want to show you guys how you can activate the Path Tracer whenever working with VDBs inside of Unreal Engine 5.3. Now to get started, whenever I start off a fresh new project, I come down here and I usually start with a blank project here inside of film, video, and live elements. And then over here on the right-hand side, I usually activate ray tracing. Now you need ray tracing in order to use Path Tracer, but if you did start a scene without the ray tracing enabled, let me show you exactly the steps that you need to take to get that activated within your scene. So I'm inside of Unreal Engine 5.3 right now, and if I come up here to edit and then come down here to project settings, over on the left hand side we're going to look for rendering. So it should be here under engine, and here it is right here. So I'm going to click on rendering. And then I want to look for ray tracing hardware. So I'm going to keep scrolling down here. You can always search, but I just want to show you guys where it's at if you don't search for it. So under rendering, hardware, ray tracing, right here, support hardware ray tracing, make sure this is turned on. And then the path tracing, make sure this is also turned on. So with those two things turned on, you're ready to start with the path tracer. So now back inside of Unreal Engine 5.3 with everything opened up, I'm going to come over here to where I have my sequencer set up already. So I'm going to open my level sequence, and down here you can see I already have it playing back within the sequencer. Now if you want to know how to set this up, I already did a tutorial. I'll link that down below, and also I'll link it inside the video here, but I have the VDB playing inside the sequencer, so we're able to render it out. So if we want to enable path tracing for this, it's as easy as coming up here to where it says lit, and then you're just going to look for path tracing. So I'm going to left click on this, and now you can see we have the path tracing bar loading up here at the bottom, but we have nothing inside of our scene. And so in order to be able to see this VDB, we have to use a console command, which is down here at the very bottom. So down here, you're just going to start by typing r.pathtracing.het. And once you start typing it out, you should see it right here. It's the heterogeneous volumes. So I'm going to left click on this, and then you want to hit the space bar and then number one, and you're going to hit enter. So now you should start seeing your VDB within the viewport down here. So once again, I'm just going to type in r.pathtracing, just in case you guys need to see it again, .het. And then you want to use this top one here at the very top, and then you would just hit space bar, number one, and then hit enter, and you should be good to go, and you'll see it within your viewport right here. Now I'm not going to go through all the path tracing settings. I actually have a tutorial dedicated to the path tracer. So if you want to go in there and see what kind of settings I usually rock with, make sure you look at that video after you're done watching this one. But inside of our scene, as I scroll through here, you can actually see that our light, I just have a regular light source here, the default one, and it's actually interacting with our VDB. So we have shadows on here, and it's starting to look pretty cool, but it is pretty fuzzy here. So if you did want to control some of that stuff, I would just come over here and add a post-pros volume. So right here where we have the cube, and then come down here to visual effects, post-pros volume. And then down here inside the details panel, I'm going to type in UNB. That's going to bring up infinite extent unbound. Means everything that I do inside of my scene is actually going to be in the entire scene, not just the volume box right here. But if I actually pull this up a little bit, let's scroll down here and let's look for path tracer. So I'm just going to keep scrolling down until you see path tracing right here. So you could turn some of these on. As I said, I'm not going to go through all of these in here, but these are the settings that you're going to want to mess with whenever you're working with the path tracer inside of your scene here. And also, if you're wondering how I got the VDB to play inside the sequencer to begin with, again, I have a tutorial dedicated to that. So I'm going to leave all the links down below for all the tutorials that you need to get yourself set. So moving on, we're going to try to render this out. So if I come down here inside of my sequencer and I just clip on this clipboard like so, if you come over here where it says unsaved config, I'm going to left click on this. I'm just going to leave the JPEG for right now. I mean, it's just a tutorial. But the one thing that we want to do is down here under rendering, I'm actually going to delete this out. So where we see settings, we have the green plus sign plus settings. I'm going to left click on this, and then I'm going to come down to where we see path tracer all the way down here at the bottom. So if I left click on this, that's all you had to do to activate the path tracer. Now, I mean, it's basically that just to get the path tracer rendered out. But if you render it just like this, it's going to be very fuzzy. So what you want to do is come up here and add some anti-aliasing. What I did for my example there, I just put this up to like 500. It did take like 30 minutes for it to render out, but the more samples you have, the better you're going to get. But it depends on your GPU as well. So if I come right here where it says override anti-aliasing, I'm going to left click on this, and that's all I basically did for this scene here. But once again, make sure you watch my path tracing tutorial, because I go through step by step with all the different settings mean to give you the optimal results for your render. So that's basically it. It's just the console command down there to be able to see it inside the viewport, and you should be good. So if this did help you out, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new. Leave me a comment down below. And speaking of the comments, make sure you look in the comments, because that's where I'm going to be putting all the links to all the tutorials that's going to get you set with VDBs to begin with setting up the master material, with setting it up inside the sequencer, and then of course this one to get it with the path tracer. So until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.